Well, none of us is immune to COVID-19, but health experts have warned that it can be more dangerous to vulnerable populations like the elderly. Last week, Tennessee's governor provided some direction for long-term retirement and assisted living facilities. And this morning, we're getting a glimpse into how one Mid-South facility is working to protect its residents. Here with us, thanks to video conferencing, is Trezevant Manor's Paul Martin. Paul is the director of the infection control team there at Trezevant. Welcome, Paul. Thank you for your time. How are you this morning?
I'm doing well, Mary Beth. How are you?
Awesome. I am as good as can be expected. We're all just taking it one day at a time. So when did Trezevant begin taking some serious steps to look into changing the way you do business because of COVID-19?
We started back March 1st taking a look at everything that we were doing right after the Kirkland, Washington nursing home came onto the news. And so over the course of the last several weeks, under the guidance of CMS, CDC, Tennessee Department of Health, we have slowly made changes, measured changes to ensure that we're meeting all of the regulatory requirements, but also all of the recommendation and guidance that's coming down. So it's been a process that we feel like we have executed pretty successfully so far.
So what is the biggest change for residents that they feel every day? Is it the lack of people's ability to visit, or what's the biggest change?
The biggest change is the lack of visitors. So the campus is restricting all visitors and families from coming onto campus, which means that unfortunately a lot of families aren't able to communicate like they normally have. And so we've been trying to find different ways for families to interact and make sure that they're not being isolated. The other thing that we've done is making sure that all packages now that come into the building are being wiped down and disinfected. So instead of packages being delivered directly to the room, we're actually having them delivered outside, and then the staff is actually disinfecting them and bringing them into the building.
What are some creative ways you're dealing with the potential isolation? Because, you know, as we referenced at the top of the show, we don't know how long this is going to go on. And that social isolation can be really anxiety producing for anyone. But I would imagine it could be a little bit worse for the elderly, whose social group is a little smaller anyway.
It is. And so what we've done is use Skype. We've used FaceTime to communicate. We've checked with our regulatory agencies. And now if you are on campus and you want to come visit a friend or a relative, what we've been able to do is have them come to a glass door. And so we're keeping that separation while we're still allowing family members to see each other and talk to each other, which has really helped in a lot of ways.
Imagine. What's been the residents' reaction so far to all of this?
They have been very positive, and they've been very much agreeable to everything that we're doing. They understand that while it is an inconvenience, everything that Trezevant has done has been to protect their health, their safety, along with all the staff that's also on campus.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your work, Paul. And we just hope that this will be over sooner rather than later for everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.